Yeah, fine. Very good afternoon to one and all. Myself, Dr. Vijay Nirmala, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Management Studies, Adishankara Group of Institutions. Today, we are going to discuss about the problems in a linear program. So this topic is there for you in operations research for MBA first year, second semester students. Already in the previous class, we have discussed about how you have to formulate LPP and the model also we have explained, right? And now, first, it is very important for us to formulate this LPP. Okay, other than that, you need to improve how you have to solve the problems using a linear programming in graphical method as well as in simplex method. So LPP consists of two types. One is graphical method and the other one is simplex method. Even though if you are using simplex method or the graphical method, whatever it may be, you have to formulate how the problem is being, whatever the problem is being given. Formulation matram, it is compulsory that you have to prepare. So, first in today's session, we also will go through some more examples how we have to formulate the problems, right? Now, let us see the first example. Yeah, we'll see the problem thoroughly. And have you are ready with your books and calculator says everything ready, I think. And now let us see the problem. The cycle trends is introducing two new lightweight bicycle frames. So first, I am reading the problem. You be thorough, okay? Don't wander somewhere. Cycle Trends is introducing two new lightweight bicycle frames. One is deluxe and the other one is professional. One is deluxe and the other one is professional to be made with aluminium and steel alloys. One is aluminium and steel alloys. So the anticipated unit profits are anticipated unit profits are 10 rupees per deluxe and 15 rupees per the professional. 15 rupees per the professional. So the number of pounds, so it is there in terms of pound. The number of pounds of each alloy needed per frame is summarized in the next. In the next, they have given a supplier delivers 100 pounds of the aluminium alloy and 80 pounds of the steel alloy weekly. Steel alloy weekly. So, how many deluxe and professional frames should the Cycle Trend produce each week? So, this is the problem they have given, and also they have given on the pound that the deluxe is giving two aluminium alloys per week and three steel alloys per week, whereas the professional is giving four aluminium alloys and two steel alloys per week. So this is the problem they have given and they asked me for the solution. First of all, try to understand what the problem is. There is a company called Cycle Trends. There is a company called Cycle Trends and it is introducing lightweight bicycles. Bicycles, you know, right? Cycles. So they are introducing two new lightweight bicycle frames. Two new lightweight bicycles. So the frames, the bicycle frames that they are introducing, right? How many they are introducing? Two. What are those two? One is the deluxe and the other one is professional. One is deluxe and the other one is professional. So deluxe bicycle frame and the other one is professional bicycle frame. Okay, so to be made, and these two are made with two types of alloys. One is aluminium alloy, the other one is steel alloy. Okati aluminium to tayar chestunnaru, inkokati steel alloy to chestunnaru. I think you understood up to here. Yeah, Cycle Trends is a company that is introducing two new lightweight bicycle frames. Okay, and the names of these two new lightweight bicycle frames are Deluxe and Professionals, and these are made with aluminium and steel alloys. Okay, so the anticipated profits. So in the problem itself, they have given about profits. So once you came to know that this problem is related to profits or cost. So in the question itself, they have gave that the anticipated unit profits are, for deluxe it is 10 rupees and for professional it is 15. That already they have given, right? So the number of pounds. See the number of pounds. So this is the one. What are the two frames? Ma? One is the deluxe frame, the other one is professional frame. One is deluxe frame and the other one is professional frame. And we are using two alloys, right? One is aluminium alloy and the other one is steel alloy. So these already they have given the pounds. Okay. So related to pounds, they have given. So two for deluxe aluminium alloy, and for deluxe 3 steel alloys, 3 pounds of steel alloys, and for professional it is 4 aluminium alloys, and for a professional a steel it is 2 steel aluminium alloys. I think this also you understood, right? And next, what they said, ma, a supplier he delivers 100 pounds of aluminium alloys and 80 pounds of steel alloy weekly. So the supplier, what he does, ma, he delivers how many per week? 100 pounds per aluminium alloy and 80 pounds per steel alloy. Okay. Now what they are asking is, how many deluxe and professional frames should Cycle Trend produce each week? So that you leave it. Okay, we are not discussing about the problem here. We are discussing only how to write the model of LPP. That's it. Okay, now shall we start the solution? Did you understand the problem? Problem at the mind, ma? Among these two, they have given the two alloys, they have given the two time frames, and they have given each pound what will be there. And whether this problem is related to maximization of profits or minimization of cost, which is it is related, which for which is left. Already in the question itself, they have given regarding the profits here, right? The profits. So the anticipated unit profit. When the question, if you see, wherever the profit ane padam kanipiste, it is that it is a maximization profit, maximization. So in the optimization, maximizing profits and minimizing cost, right? So whether, first of all, you need to understand whether this problem is related to maximization problem or minimization problem, that you have to identify. Did you identify which problem is this? It is maximization problem. Now let us see the solution. See, first one, first define the objective. Define the objective. So what is the objective? To maximize the total weekly profit. To maximize the total weekly profit. So that is the objective, right? Next, when once you define the objectives, what you have to do, ma? You need to define the decision variables. Do you know how many deluxe frames you produce weekly? We don't know. Do you know how many professional frames that we need to produce weekly? That also we don't know. In the previous problem, we have discussed about tables and chairs. Sorry. So let X be, let T be the number of tables that they have been produced per week, and C be the number of chairs that are being produced per week. Ani manam already we have discussed in the previous problem. Now, that for your understanding purpose, I have said it as a table, T for table, C for chair. Now you have become more comfortable with LPP, right? Now, the decision variables, generally, we can take X1 and X2. Or also, you can take X and Y also. You can take it as X and Y also. Now, generally, I use X1 and X2. So that let X1 be the number of deluxe frames. X1 be the number of deluxe frames which are being produced weekly. X1 anukuntam amma per week. The deluxe frames that are being produced are X1. Let it be. Okay. And the other one is let X2. X2 be the number of professional frames which are produced weekly. I think you are understandable. The first one is you have to define what is the objective, whether it is a maximization problem or minimization cost, that you have to write. And in the next one, you need to define the decision variables. Let it be X1 for deluxe frames and X2 for professional frames. That what we are going to identify, that we have to define here. Defining of the decision variables, right? Now, you write a solution. See. This is the solution that how we have written. Maximization problem, right? It is maximize Z is equal to X1 and X2. How you wrote this 10 and 15? Already in this problem, they said that 10 for deluxe, 15 for professional. See the problem here. 10 for deluxe, 15 for professional, right? So maximize Z is equal to, we thought deluxe as X1. Professional as X2. So, maximization Z is equal to 10X1 plus 15X2. 10X1 plus 15X2. That's what we have written here. Maximize Z is equal to 10X1 plus 15X2. Did you understand how we got the first step? This one. Maximize Z is equal to 10X1 plus 15X2. If in the problem they used to give about profits, you write profits there. If they ask you, they write, tell you about cost, there also simply we write minimum Z is equal to 10x1 plus 15x2. Minimum Z is equal to 10x1 plus 15x2. So here minimum, if you write, these 10 and 15 are not profits. Those are cost. It is related to the cost that you have to remember. Okay, next, subject to, you should write, what is the next step when we write this after completing the decision variables? You have to write, so you need to write the objective function. So you have frame, so in the same previous problem, you have written the decision variables as X1 and X2. And you have also already wrote the objective function. The objective function is maximization profit. So maximize z is equal to 10x1 plus 15x2. And later on, what you have to write, ma? You have to write the constraints subject to. You should write like this, subject to the constraints that you have to write. So what are the constraints? Let us see. So in this problem, the deluxe, which is called x1, right? Here you write it, you can, if you in the bracket also, you can write it as X1 as a deluxe, we thought X2 as professional. X1 as a deluxe and X2 as, just wait. Whiteboard, I'll check. Yeah. See. This will be a deluxe, let this deluxe be of X1 and professional be of X2. So, what we can write here? when you come with when you are writing about deluxe and professional related to aluminium foil, aluminium alloy, you have write 2x1 plus 4x2, 2x1 plus 4x2. You have to write in this way, ma'am. In this way, you have to write 2x1 plus 4x2. So that you have to write. Okay, 2x1 plus 4x2. That you have to write. So 2x1 plus 4x2 is here. What is it, ma'am? The aluminium alloys must deliver 100 pounds only per a week. 100 pounds only per a week. So this is the constraint that already they have given in the problem. Aluminium alloys B. So this is aluminium alloy. These two they have to produce must be less than or equal to. They should supply all. They should deliver only 100 pounds of aluminium alloys and only 80 pounds of steel alloy. Only 80 pounds of steel alloy BP. So what we have written? 2x1 plus, see this one. Alpha aluminium alloy we are writing. It means that you have to see right like this. 2x1 plus 4x2 is less than or equal to 100. Why we have written less than or equal to there? They have written the constraint that a supplier must deliver only 100 pounds or equal to 100 pounds or less than 100 pounds, but not more than 100 pounds. But not more than 100 pounds. So that is the constraint here. So what you have wrote here, 2x1 plus 4x2 is less than or equal to 100, is less than or equal to. Next, come to the next constraint. Coming to the steel alloy. 3x1, x1 in the sense for deluxe, we call this as, right? So 3x1 plus 2x2 is 80 pounds here. See the problem. 80 pounds of the steel alloy weekly. 80 pounds of the steel alloy a weekly, right? So here 80 pounds in the sense he need to deliver at least 80, only 80 pounds or equal to 80 pounds, but not more than 80 pounds, but not more than 80 pounds. So here what we wrote, ma, 3x1 plus 2x2 is less than or equal to 80, is less than or equal to 80. And the last step, you have to write the non-negativity constraint that no, the X1, that is the deluxe or the professional cycle frames must not be non-negative, right? It means that it should not be negative. It should be positive only. That is, it must be greater than zero. So that here we have written X1 comma X2 is greater than or equal to zero. X1 comma X2 is greater than or equal to zero. Now, did you understand the problem, ma? I think you understood. Anybody can type in the chat box. At least I can understand that whether you have understood the problem or not. Adhvaindu, ma, Cycle Trends company is being introducing this new lightweight bicycle frames with aluminium and steel alloys, right? So that we have. So this is the solution how we are writing. So maximize Z is equal to 10x1 plus 15x2 subject to the constraints 2x1 plus 4x2, which is less than or equal to 100. 3x1 plus 2x2 is less than or equal to 80, whereas x1 and x2 are greater than or equal to 0. Greater than or equal to 0. I think you understood this problem. If anybody wants to write, you can write it. Okay. Shall we move to the next problem? Will you do this one? I will tell. I will explain you the problem. You just write it down. How to frame this LPP? LPP formulation, you just write. First, we'll understand how we have to write LPP formulation, right? If anybody wants to write, you can write this solution, ma. Or else I'll share the PPT to you also, that by that you can watch. Shall we move with the other problem? Yeah, fine. Yes. See, here, a company, a firm manufactures three products. See that a firm is manufacturing three products. One is A, the other one is B, and the next one is C. A firm is manufacturing three products, A, comma B, and
Daddy, पूरा
हाँ क्लास डर तो मार
हरीचंद
देता
A firm is manufacturing three products, A, comma B and C. So the profits are 3 rupees, 2 rupees, and 4 rupees respectively. In the problem they have given, the profits are 3 rupees, 2 rupees, and 4 rupees respectively. Okay, so the firm has two machines. The firm is having two machines, and below is the required processing time in minutes. In minutes for each machine on each product. For each machine on each product. I think you understood this one. A firm is there that it is manufacturing three types of products. One is A product, B product, and C product. And already in the problem, they have given that the profits. The profits are 3 rupees, 2 rupees, and 4 rupees respectively. And a firm is having two machines. One is G machine and the other one is G machine, the other one is H machine, right? And the processing time is being given in minutes. That is, in machine G, if you want to produce A product, it takes 4 minutes time. Please, please understand what I am telling. In machine G, if you want to produce A product, it takes how much time? Processing time they have given 4 minutes. In the same machine G, if you want to produce B product, if you want to produce B product, it takes 3 minutes time. It takes 3 minutes time. So in the same way, if you want to produce C product in G machine, I'm discussing only about G machine here, right? C product in G machine, it takes 5 minutes time. So this is about machine G. And there is another machine called H. And if you want to produce A product in H machine, it takes 2 minutes time. And if you want to produce B product in H machine, also it takes 2 minutes time. And if you want to produce C product in H machine, it takes 4 minutes time. It takes 4 minutes time. Okay, did you understand up to here? Yeah, this box, I think you understood. Yes. Next, machine G and H. Up to now, they have said about the products and the timings and also the profits that they have been given. And now I think they are telling about constraints. Now let us see. Machine G and H, they have 2000 and 2000 machine, 2000 and 2500 machine minutes respectively. So machine G is having 2000 minutes. Machine H is having 2500 minutes, right? It means that this is the constraint, right? Constraint laga anipistunda meeku. Yes. Ante machine G will work for 2000 minutes and machine H will work for is having 2500 minutes ani cheptunnaru. So next, what they are telling, the firm must manufacture 100 A's, 200 B's, and 50 C's. So it has to make 100 A's. That is, it needs to produce 100 A products, 200 B products, and 50 C products. 50 C products. So that is one constraint they have given, and also another more, but not more than 150 A's. That is, you need to manufacture 100 A's, but not more than 150 A's. So it means that compulsory you need to manufacture 100. So 100, but less than 150. Less than 150. So see that terminology, how they are using in the problem. And now, what the setup an LP problem to maximize the profits. In the problem itself, they have given maximization profit. So whether this problem is related to maximization problem or minimization problem, can you guess? Here you have given, in this problem, they have given two things that to guess whether if this problem is related to maximization problem or minimization problem. See, what are the two clues? Tell me. Here in the first sentence, they have given the profits here. Profit ane padam ganpichindi ante, it means that it is a maximization problem. And also in the last, they have set up an LP model to maximize profits. So for your understanding, I have put that maximize profit. But in some, in your exam point of view, they don't ask set up an, they simply ask set up an LP problem. That's all. They do not tell about maximize profits. Okay. So in the question, you don't get that direct questions. So by reading the problem itself, you need to understand whether the problem is maximization or minimization. So this you just leave the last line. In the first line, they have given profits, right? So in the problem, they have given profits. It means that this problem is related to maximization, right? So this is the problem. Let us see how the solution will be there. First, what you have to define, ma? You have to define the objective. You have to define the objective. So what is the objective? Whether it is maximization profit or minimization cost? It is related to maximization problem. It is related to maximization problem. So that is pakka. We know that you define the objectives, right? Next, when once you have defined the objectives, you need to define the decision variable. Here, how many products are there? If you have how many products, that much of decision variables you need to define. So you have A product, B product, and C product. So what you do is, so how many products that we are purchasing, that only know they have asked us how many products that you need to manufacture, that they are asking. So it means that how many products in the sense, let X1 be the number of products of type A product. Let X1 be the number of products of type A, and X2 be the number of products of type B, and X3 be the number of products of type C. You can call it as also X, Y, Z also you can put it as. Okay, you can put like X be the number of products of type A, Y be the number of products of type B, Z be the number of products of type C. If there are given more than that, so that's one. That's why what we do is we prefer X1, X2, and X3. These only we used to prefer X1, X2, X3. How many products they may give? They give more than three. At that time, you have to search for the alphabets, other alphabets, right? So this is will be comfortable to you, X1, X2, and X3. So this is the first step. What you have defined? You have defined the objective function and you have defined the decision variables, right? Up to here, you are understandable, I think. Yeah. See, see the solution. Yeah. Maximize z is equal to, it is a maximized problem, right? So we have wrote max z is equal to x1, x2, x3. That also we know. Already we have defined the decision variables, right? Where are these 3, 2 and 4? Yeah, where you have brought these 3, x1, 3, 2 and 4? Where you have identified? You can see in the problem already, in the profits they have given 3 rupees, 4 rupees and, 3 rupees, 2 rupees and 4 rupees respectively. That already they have given in the problem. That only we have wrote 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3. Profits గురించి ఇస్తే profits ఏ రాస్తాము, cost గురించి ఇస్తే cost ఏ రాస్తాము, right? I think you understood. Okay. Max z is equal to 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3. Okay, next you have to write, you have framed this one, right? What we call that one, maximize it, that what generally we call it as objective function. We call it as objective function. First max z is equal to 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3. This we call it as objective function. So first, when once the objective function is framed, you have to write the constraints. You need to write the constraints. Right? So subject to and cheptam. You will write subject to. And next you have to write the constraints. See the constraints. What are they? Machine G and H they have given here. See that. Machine G uses to produce 2000 minutes. And the machine H uses to work on 2500 minutes. Creature that they have given, right? So then what you have to write for each product? So like A is for X1, B is for X2, C is for X3. So what for the first constraint, what you have to write? 4X1 plus 3X2 plus 5x3 is less than or equal to 2000. Is less than or equal to antenama 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3 is less than or equal to 2000. Is less than or equal to 2000. I think you understood the equation, right? And the other one, what they have given in the problem, machine H. For machine H, it is 2500, right? 2500. So, so X1, X2, X3, right? So, what you have to write here? 2X1 plus 2X2 plus 4X3 less than or equal to how much? 2500. See this. 2x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3 is less than or equal to 2500. Did you understand the constraints how to write? Yeah, ichina problem ni batte manam rastam amma. Okay. So this is how we have it. And there are other constraints also other than this. The total G machine has to work only for 2000 minutes. And that, sorry. And the total machine H has to work only for 2500 minutes. That they have given. So we have wrote that one, that constraints. Other than that also they have given constraints. See that the firm must manufacture 100 A's. 200 B's, 50 C's, but not more than 150 A's. So, leave first, leave it A1. A and A in the micromanaki, A means X1, B means X2, C means X3. That we have already discussed, right? So, first leave A. Why? Because here they have given one more thing, but not more than one thing. So 200 bees, should the per must manufacture 200 bees. Compulsory, it has to manufacture 200 bees. Also more than that. So you have wrote here x2 greater than or equal to 200. Rendu vandalu kachitanga cheyali. Anedi cheppunnadu here. Anama, in this problem, what they have said? The firm must manufacture 200 bees. So the bee product must be in a week. It has to manufacture compulsory 200 products. Or more than that also you can produce. More than that also you can produce. So that's why you have wrote x2 is greater than or equal to 200. So equal to 200 or greater than 200, that you can. And the next one is, the firm must manufacture 50 C's. 50 C's. So the same version x3. C ante x3. X3 is greater than or equal to 50. X3 is greater than or equal to 50. I think you understood x2 and x3. Okay. And next, let us come to this. A firm must manufacture 100 A's. Kachitanga 100 A's cheyali and cheppadu. It means you can write x1 greater than or equal to 100. Greater than or equal to 100. That below 100, it should not be done. Ante kadamma, that meaning a firm must manufacture 100 A's. It means it should manufacture at least 100 or more than 100, but not below 100. But not below 100. Vanda lopu cheyakoddu. Vandanna cheyochu, vanda above anna cheyochu. And you also can write x1 greater than or equal to 100. But here they have given another one. But not more than 150. But not more than 150. So this is related to A only. A product only. A product should be manufactured 100. But not more than 150. And 100, for example, for B, you have a wrote greater than 200. You can prepare 300 also. You can prepare 400 also. You can prepare 500 also. Okay. But for X1, they have given a constraint that you can, you have to prepare 100, but not more than 150. It means that, see how you have wrote 100 less than or equal to x1, less than or equal to 150, less than or equal to 150. Ante x1 product, ante a product, it must have been less than or equal to 150, less than or equal to 150, but here it has to be 100, right? So 100 less than or equal to x1, less than or equal to 150, less than or equal to 150. I think you understood this problem. Huh? The firm must manufacture 100 A's. Vanda cheyali ante vanda ninchi 150 lope. Vanda ninchi 150 lope. So then how you have to write the equation? 100 less than or equal to x1, less than or equal to 150. That you have to write. That you have to write. And the last remaining non-negativity you have to write, right? X1, x2, and x3 greater than or equal to 0. X1, x2, and x3 greater than or equal to 0. I think you understood this problem also. If you have any queries, you can type in the chat box. I think you are writing. Are you maintaining a book for this or not? Book petara? Yeah, fine. You have to write regarding this. Shall we move to the other problem? Have you wrote the solution, ma'am? Maximize z is equal to 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3 subject to the constraints 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3, which is less than or equal to 2000. What is that 2000, ma? Minutes. 2000 is a minutes. And when you come to the next machine, H, 2x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3, less than or equal to 2500, where here 2500 is also a minutes, right? And these are the constraints that they have given. So with this we will conclude today's session, and in the next session we'll discuss some more problems related to minimization also. Okay, so that we'll discuss in the next session. Okay, and with this we'll conclude as today's session. If you have any queries, you can ask me, or else we'll wind up. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.